show. You know, these days there's no such thing as a safe investment, but with the right guidance, investing in real estate could lead to some nice returns. Here to show us how is Lee Kiser of the Kiser Group. Welcome, Lee.
Good morning, Ray.
Good morning. So how is the real estate market doing in Chicago right now?
It's tough.
It's tough everywhere, right?
It's tough everywhere in Chicago. You know, we never have the highs that the coasts have. We never have the really lows, but it's a tough market right now.
Why does it stay? It kind of stays in between. Why do you think that is?
Chicago and the Midwest in general just doesn't have the peaks, the escalations in value. Historically, it's always been that way here.
So we're going to get to some great values that you found here in the Chicagoland area. But first, let's go to your do's and don'ts. Number one, of course, do your homework. That's a given.
Always do your homework. Go online, look at crime reports, walk the neighborhood at night, talk to neighbors, learn what you can about the neighborhood.
Right, so do your homework, and also, number two, hire the right professionals.
Yeah, if you're sick, don't self-diagnose and try to cure yourself. Even the most savvy real estate investors are going to hire the right attorney, the right lender, the right broker, the right inspector. Make sure you have the right team together.
Okay, and number three, if buying in Cook County, check property tax and then protest the assessment?
Yeah. In Cook County, property taxes, if you own in Cook County, you know, are always the wild card. So make sure you carefully look at the tax assessment, the market valuation. There's a whole industry in Chicago of protests. You can do it yourself, hire the right attorney, and always protest your taxes in Cook County.
Do a lot of people win? I mean, you protest, does it go in your favor?
Many times it does. The fortunate thing if you're using an attorney is that the attorney only gets paid if they're successful in a reduction.
Right. What about multiple properties? You always want to do that. You got to have options, right?
Yeah. Look at multiple properties. You know, rarely does someone marry after the first date.
Mm-hmm.
Take your time. You know, it's a lot easier to go look at properties than it is to find multiple dates. Use it. Go look at lots of properties.
All right, look at lots of properties and trust your instinct.
Yeah, you know, if you've done all your homework, you've hired the right professionals, sometimes you see an opportunity where you think there's the right angle on it or it makes sense for you. Trust your instincts and go with them.
Okay, so those are the do's. Now let's check out the don'ts. You just talked about dating. Number one, don't fall in love.
Yes, do not fall in love with real estate.
Okay.
It should not be an emotional purchase. I love that Jerusalem stone in the kitchen. It's not the reason to buy the house.
Yeah, but a lot of people do that, right? It's like impulse buying. It's like when you're at the grocery store, you know, you're hungry, you want to buy the bad stuff. Or when you're at, you know, buying clothing, it's the same kind of thing.
So your best purchase in real estate will be the one where that was not your guidance.
Yeah, okay, the other don'ts quickly, don't buy a rental investment if you can't afford the payment. Don't think any property is perfect, plan for the unexpected, and don't be afraid to make an offer even if you think it's too low.
Right.
Tell us about that.
In this market, it's a buyer's market. If everything else lines up and you're worried about offending someone, don't be.
Right.
Make the offer.
All right, now let's take a look at some properties that you found. The first one is in Lakeview. It's $200,000, very reasonable. Tell us about this one.
Well, and we looked at properties that were $200,000 and what it might buy you in different areas. In Lakeview, that will buy you a two-bedroom, one-bath condominium, pretty close to the lake, some nice features. If you're looking at it to live there yourself, that's one thing. If you're looking at it as an investment, you can rent that out for approximately $1,740 a month. If you annualize your returns, you're looking at about just over a 9% annual return on your equity.
Okay, great. That one's in Lakeview. How about Mount Prospect?
In Mount Prospect, $200,000, you should expect to be able to buy a three-bedroom, two-bath house. Now, the one that you're looking at is a short sale.
Mm-hmm.
And it says work needed. Short sale means that the asking price of the property is below the existing mortgage amount, which means you'll probably need the seller's lender's approval for it. It also indicates there may be a good value and a good purchase here. In this example, if you were to rent this out, it'd be about $1,750 per month, or mm-hmm. about a 9.5% return on your equity annually.
Okay, Lee, how about our last one in Aurora?
You're looking at also about a three-bedroom, two-bath house. This one's on a quiet cul-de-sac. However, your rent in Aurora is lower. You would rent that out for just over $1,500 per month, cutting your annual return approximately in half from what you had in Mount Prospect.
All right, Lee, thanks so much for the info. Really appreciate you being here.
Thank you. My pleasure.
All right, well, our next guest thinks that you should give away three-quarters of your clothes. We're cleaning out our closets and later tips of the perfect barbecue to end the summer. We'll be right back with more Windy City Live.